the people are electing the government to rule us well. So if the government does not rule us well, the social contract is broken. Then one of the other things that is affecting people in Zimbabwe is the deployment of the military and the militarization of civilian areas. In my eyes, I was, as a responsible citizen, engaging in expression and discussion around the problems of Zimbabwe. So I was sad when I realized that we are not allowed to do that. I feel I have to act as a Zimbabwean, because all of us should be outraged by such things and immediately say, we're going to change this. This is not Zimbabwe.
What that arrest represents is the deteriorating human rights situation in Zimbabwe, where people are no longer free. And we've known that Zimbabweans are not free, but now if you cannot step outside your home to protest against the national crisis, the hunger crisis, the public health crisis, the corruption crisis, it tells a story. You don't call legitimate critics dark forces, terrorists, bad apples. The Constitution gives people the right to freely express themselves. It gives people the right to challenge the system. Everything that the president said yesterday was patently unconstitutional. It was an act of intimidation. It was threatening.